What's up, everybody? My name is Andrew Jones. I'm the Big Blue VA, and this is a little show I like to call a Lotta Yadda. I've been playing around with the idea of this show after watching two of my friends, Jess and Haley, with their respective shows, The Works and Off the Cuff, which I will be linking their channels in the description down below so you guys can go give them some love. Please do. But the main reason I wanted to do this show is because I wanted to talk about and share my experiences with some of the things that interested me growing up, as well as the things that just inspired me in general to be a creator. Now, this doesn't mean that I won't be doing any more comedy or story voiceover videos. Far from it, in fact. I actually have two in the works right now that I'll be doing with everybody's favorite little devil darling, Bendy, later down the line. And I might even dabble a little bit more into Glamrock Bonnie from Five Nights at Freddy's Security Breach. I know how much you guys love him, but I just have a lot of other projects planned that I'm pretty sure you guys are going to love. I don't know how long I'm going to be making this little video series for. It will probably be determined later down the line, but either way, I hope you guys enjoyed this very first episode of A Lotta Yadda.
Thinking of you wherever you are, we pray for our sorrows to end and hope that our hearts will blend.
Now I will step forward to realize this wish. And who knows? Starting a new journey may not be so hard. Or maybe it's already begun. There are many worlds, but they share the same sky. One sky, one destiny.
I remember walking down the video game aisle of our local Target, back when supermarkets still had those demo kiosks installed. It was my 15th, 16th birthday, and I was with my dad at the time, and he asked me what video game did I want for a gift. And after looking through the displays, I happened to see the Greatest Hits version of Kingdom Hearts 2 for PlayStation 2. At the time, I had heard some of my classmates talking about Kingdom Hearts, and they liked it, so I figured, eh, why not? Might as well give it a try. And upon going home and booting up the PlayStation 2 and watching that famous opening cutscene, I knew I was immediately hooked. The story may be a little messy, and the lore convoluted, but if there's one thing that Kingdom Hearts is fantastic at doing, it's pulling in its audience. Teenage me was so enamored with trying to find out more about these characters and their stories. Meeting Roxas, finding out who Sora is, asking the question, who is Naminé, and who is this mysterious girl on the beach named Kairi? And why are Donald and Goofy in this game? I had to find out why, and I think that that was the linchpin that sent me spiraling down the rabbit hole into this series. One of the things that really grabbed me was just how different the game had been from all the other games that I had played up until that point. Keep in mind, most of my video game experiences before Kingdom Hearts had been with platformers, so a lot of the video games that I played were Sonic the Hedgehog, Jak and Daxter, Super Mario World, Ty the Tasmanian Tiger. These were the video games that my brother and I had at the time, but after being introduced to RPGs, my taste in video games widened exponentially. I started falling in love with the Elder Scrolls series, Fallout, Final Fantasy, Persona. It all started with Kingdom Hearts. I mentioned earlier that the story is convoluted, but it really isn't. The reason it was so convoluted to myself and other fans of the series was because after Kingdom Hearts 2, the games started releasing in that weird prequel side story kind of order. Birth by Sleep was a prequel, 358 Days Over 2 was a B story to Chain of Memories, Coded and Recoded were epilogues, you get the point. I admit starting with the third game in the series up until that point probably wasn't the best idea either, but as I got older and I started playing the games more, I started to understand the story a little bit clearer. I'm not going to go into broad strokes with how the games play out, God knows I put my friends through hell explaining it to them, but the short and dirty version is, Three kids named Sora, Riku, and Kairi set out from their island home in search of grand adventure. Darkness strikes the island, and the three get separated, and Sora, now the chosen wielder of a weapon known as the Keyblade, accompanied by Royal Wizard Donald Duck and Captain of the Royal Guard Goofy, must travel through different Disney worlds in search of Kairi and Riku while trying to banish the growing threat of the Heartless and Darkness along the way. I think another thing that really surprised me with this game was also just how well the characters were written. Every character, even some of the side characters, have such good development arcs through the series. Trust me, if you guys are fans of RPGs, or if you are hardcore Disney fans in general, I'd highly recommend giving these games a try if you haven't yet. So, I mentioned earlier that I put my friends through hell explaining the lore of Kingdom Hearts, and guys, when I tell you the lore is deep, I mean that Five Nights at Freddy's has nothing on this. I actually made a PowerPoint presentation that goes over the lore of Kingdom Hearts that I presented to some of my friends, and this presentation took almost 4 hours to get through, and it was 110 slides long. I am not kidding you. It took 2 weeks to put that damn thing together, and you guys are about to see the highlights of that presentation in a few moments. But, real quick, I want to give a huge thank you to my friends for taking part in that presentation, and I also apologize. I really do. I am so sorry, guys. I am going to leave links in their social medias in the description down below, so you all can go check them out and do give them some love. They really deserve it. But I'd also like to thank all of you guys for watching. I've been the Big Blue VA, and I'll see you again if the creek don't rise. Welcome, guys, to a comprehensive-ish summary on the Kingdom Hearts series.
Ooh. Animations.
Oh. Yeah, yeah.
Hey, Windows Movie Maker.
Dead-ass Windows Movie Maker animations. So,
this
all right.
This is part of the Onyx memory. This is my new key animation memory.
All we're missing is the hyper-saturated slides.
Oh, just wait. We'll get there.
I have a question.
Go ahead.
Master of Masters, did he give himself that title?
Yes.
Okay. You know he did.
You know he did. You know he did.
I am the best.
Together with a head.
Yeah. If you hear him talking, you will immediately think, oh, he absolutely gave himself that title.
Oh, we will hear the Master of Masters talking here in a moment.
Come on, it's simple. You 6 plus me is 7. Wait, don't tell me I don't count.
This is the party throughout all of the Kingdom Hearts games. Well, most of the Kingdom Hearts games is Sora, Donald, and Goofy.
Consisting of a goof, a kid, and the strongest mage ever.
The strongest? We'll get to that. We will get to that.
The king.
The mouse shows himself. The king has returned. So Mickey shows up.
Okay, so if I get this, what you just said correctly, whoever comes into this castle is basically going to into like a perpetual, what the fuck did I come into this room here for?
Pretty much.
You're not
No,
that's hell. That's living hell.
No.
That's living like a vegetable.
No.
You have no idea how right you are.
No. Kolo, you are absolutely correct. The moment that Sora, Donald, and Goofy walk into this fucking castle, they start losing their memories.
No, that's...
Roxas leaves Organization 13, and Axel here is trying to stop him. Like, dude, if you leave the organization, they will fucking kill you. And Roxas, believing that nobodies don't have hearts, pretty much says, nobody's gonna miss me. Who cares?
Oh, shit! I'll be right back!
Okay.
Did something catch on fire?
Baby wants out. The timing of that meow, perfect.
I hope Cole is okay.
It sounds like he was gradually being turned into a cat, and then we heard the meowing over and over as he begged to be turned back.
What's going on?
Shit, it's gonna empty the top again! I'll be right back!
All I'm saying is, have we seen Kolo and that cat in the same room at the same time?
It's a conspiracy, man!
What are you talking about?
Cal, are we absolutely sure? that one of your cats... Are we absolutely positive that one of your cats is just not Kolo?
You think that Kolo would come back to California?
What a way, what a time for him to come back. Oh, gosh.
What out of context shit did I just miss again?
This mummy-looking motherfucker.
Nuts. It's nuts. I thought I'm
dizzy.
Looks like my summer vacation is over.
And thus leads...
This was all the intro?
Yeah, so from Roxas waking up to this moment right here, that was the tutorial section of Kingdom Hearts 2. Yeah, yeah.
Okay.
Yep, mm-hmm, yep, yep, wait, yep. Wait,
the tutorial?
Yep. Yeah.
Yep.
Sort of gobsmackened. I couldn't even finish it. It caught me off so caught me so off guard.
It left you gobsmacked.
It left me gobsmacked, yeah. It just now occurred to me that I'm literally putting all y'all through hell. And I'm very sorry about that.
No, you're not.
No, I'm not, but at least it's funny.
Gobsmacking back!
Darlin' and Goofled.
Oh, and Michael's there.
Yeah.
This is the weirdest shit.
What do you want now, you fucking rat? Riku has been in a different dream altogether. The reason that Sora is in a different dream is because he is dreaming within his dream. I shit you not.
So now we add Inception to the list of ripoffs.
This is the plot. So Riku goes.
Stop. Hold. Chill.
Tonight.
I'm sorry, Andrew.
Well, Sora and Riku both save her using the power of the Gay Blade. Don't ask. Using the power of the Gay Blade. Don't ask.
Oh, I'm scared. Is this like a Keyblade they have to use together?
I knew you would put it there. I knew you would put it there.
Thank you, Haley, for providing the image.
Thank you, Haley. Thank you, Haley. Kolo, you saw that, right?
Holy shit.
Yeah, Donald is canonically the strongest mage in the entire Final Fantasy franchise.
There is a world of light and darkness, a realm of reality, and then there's a world of unreality, a realm of fiction.
You mean a fuck? No. Hold the fuck up, Casey Jones. You back that train up. You back that son of a bitch right the fuck back to a station and explain to me that this whole fucking shit that went down in Kingdom Hearts is set in the real goddamn world that we fucking live in.
That's actually a theory in the community. And he's gone again.
He's living again?
I didn't know I had this kind of power over you guys. This is scary.
It leaves me wondering what would happen if I ever tried doing a presentation on Homestuck.